Hello and greetings from Iceland. Today's topic is this phenomenon, which we enjoy for 2-3 days every year, usually in January, but we call those clouds glittering clouds here in Iceland. But they usually go by the name iridescence clouds, formed of small water droplets, and this was the first show of the year. And I admit that I had been waiting for this chance, and managed to get a part of the show Saturday morning and decided to share it since it's a phenomenon that fits my channel well, especially since we have been hearing people speculate whether the volcanic eruption on Tonga last year could be helping out with the colors in the sky. But the thing is that we have been seeing unusually colorful sunrises recently, often blamed on the Tonga eruption. But as for those clouds, it's a bit more far-fetched explanation, I think. It's not for me to say, though. And unfortunately, the weather in Northern Iceland has not been particularly favorable lately due to cloud cover. So I haven't got any good images or videos from sunrises lately. But it might change soon, since the days are getting longer. And February can be gorgeous when it comes to light and colors. But I did notice 3 days ago, as I was flying the drone, that I had problems with the white balance settings that I do manually, of course. It was like a bit more magenta tone in the video than I wanted, and impossible to get rid of it with the white balance settings alone. So I did some correction work in post, or more than usual. So I will be on the lookout when the sun gets a bit higher up. But this is as good as it gets now. And when my forefathers saw those clouds, they didn't like them at all. They had their own name for them, or sea ice clouds. And they meant bad news to them, because they were telling us that the ice from Greenland would drift all the way to Iceland that spring, shut down harbors, destroy fishing nets, and then it's a cold, of course. So that was one of our old weather myths. Or until we found out that they might have been right. Those clouds can indicate strong westerly wind prevailing, spreading out the ice of East Greenland, and then it comes drifting to Iceland. And it's worth noting that the frequency of glimmering clouds seemed to increase after 1964, at the same time as sea ice increased by the coast of Iceland. And the biggest ice drift in recent years, in 2005, came after spectacular cloud shows like this, that winter. So I'm curious to see if this show will go on for some more days. But I had to move quick yesterday when I shot this, and I was better prepared Sunday morning, and I could just barely see those clouds again, just before the low clouds blocked the view, and it started to snow, just as I was getting a camera ready. So this is in a way like capturing the Northern Lights. Not the simplest thing. And if you are a tourist in Iceland now, I would be on the lookout by sunrise. You can of course capture this with any mobile phone camera. But if you are doing some serious photography or time-lapse shots like this, where I was trying to see how the colors would change or not. And I need to say that this kind of footage does easily reveal sensor dust, like I found out that my camera had. So I had to do some cleaning on those shots. And I'm not fully satisfied with the outcome. But that's just how it is. Every phenomenon has its own settings for each and every camera and the lens. But at least I got good enough files to make the colors pop a bit. And I will of course be on the lookout for more in the coming days and weeks. But this is, however, a fine winter bonus. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the colorful island, Iceland.